Praise you, Lord, I praise you. Oh, I praise you. Yes, I praise you. How I praise you, my precious Lord. I love you, Lord, I love you. Oh, I love you. Yes, I love you, Lord, I love you, my lovely Lord. You are worthy, Lord, you're worthy. So you're worthy, so worthy. Oh, you're worthy, most holy Lord.
Genesis chapter 3. We're going to read from verse 1. Genesis chapter 3, verse 1 onwards. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, Yea, hath God said, Ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden? And the woman said unto the serpent, We may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God hath said, Ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. I'm going to stop right here. God created Adam and Eve. And Adam was created by God, by God's hands, and he breathed his living breath into Adam. And then after that, God caused him to sleep, caused a deep sleep to come upon Adam, and he took his rib, one of his ribs, and he created Eve. So we have two people that God created. They were the earliest of human race, right? And for people who don't believe in creation, in a few minutes, you're going to believe in God. But I want to tell you that whether we believe this or not, it does not alter the fact that God created. So God created Adam and Eve. Adam was the first man and Eve was the first woman. And the Bible says God used to come every day. And he used to talk to them, and he used to walk with them, and they had such a beautiful time with God. One day, Satan looked at all the creatures that God created. He looked at the elephant, he looked at the monkey, he looked at the lion, he looked at the tiger, he looked at the giraffe, he looked at the turtle, he looked at the birds. But this serpent says it was so cunning. Out of all the beasts, Satan looked at it and said, this is a good candidate that I can use. How many of us know people like that in our lives? At a particular point in our time of life, Satan used a specific person, like he used the serpent to come to Eve. Out of all the beasts, the serpent was cunning. So, there are a lot of people in this world, right? There are a lot of people. People have different shortcomings. A lot of things are there. But there are specific people who will be an agent to the enemy, very easily used by the devil to draw us away from God, to take us deep into the pit. And this serpent was used by the devil. So caution number one for us is, we don't want to be one of the agents of devil at any point in our lives, right? To be used of the devil. Before we look at somebody saying that that's an agent of Satan, we got to look at ourselves, right? We have to really look at ourselves and say, am I an agent of the Lord or am I an agent of the enemy? So at this point, the serpent became an agent of the enemy. So he comes and he's asking Eve a very subtle question. He didn't come to Eve and he didn't say, hey, Eve, God is really bad. Don't believe in God. You think he created? He didn't create you. You didn't even know how you got here. He didn't say any of those things. He knows how to get to a person. He knows the weakness of each person. And it differs from person to person to person. Not everyone has the same weakness as the next person. So this Satan, who came through the serpent, studied Eve for some time. He just didn't come all of a sudden and just have a conversation with Eve. He just looked at Eve. He knew, okay, what is her interest? What is her desire? What is she up to? And he said, let me go and try. Let me approach her. And he came to Eve and he said, hath God said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden? He's asking a question. Did God tell you that? Did God tell you that you cannot eat every tree? Is that what God said? No, God said you can have all the trees, all the fruits from all the trees, but only one tree don't touch. Satan comes and he twists it. He brings the question, he's saying, God, this is not good, that's not good, that's not bad, that's not bad. And what else is good? Then life is going to be boring if you follow God, right? Satan will come and say, Christianity is boring. You can't do this, you can do that. It's full of lots of don'ts and lots of do's. Do's are difficult to do and don'ts are difficult not to do. And I'd rather just go back. That's the voice of the enemy. And he came and he told Eve, did God tell you not to eat from all the fruits of all the trees? That's not what God said. So the question came in a very subtle way. And then we're going to see how Eve responded. And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God had said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. So we know that Eve clearly knows what God said. She's really got the instruction in her. It's not like a kindergarten child or a first grade, you know, in school. You tell them, go to the office room and get the attendance book. And also get another sheet from the office. They may go halfway. They may forget the other sheet. They may get the attendance. Or they may get something else and come back. Because they didn't really get it. We need to say two times, three times, or what did I tell you? Make them repeat and then we send them. Eve really got it. Eve really got what God said. So she's actually telling the serpent. She's having conversation with the serpent. She says, God said, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden. Everything is allowed except for one, which is in the middle of the garden. And he said, you shall not eat it. You shall not touch it. If you do that, then you're going to die. Verse 4, and the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die. He's saying something contrary, right? Completely contrary to what God said. God is saying, you're going to die. The serpent says, you're not going to die. Now, who is big? The Lord. The Lord is big. And who does she really know well? God. But we see the desire that is in her. The Bible says, every man, every person is tempted according to what? The desire that they have in their heart. That means Satan comes to each person according to the weakness, according to the pull that they have in their heart toward whatever they run after. Satan is going to use that to come back to them. And so Satan says over here, you're not going to die. The first thing the enemy will do in your life and my life is to doubt what God has said. It is the integrity of God that Satan is actually questioning over here. If God said, don't touch that, that's fire. The day you touch it, you're going to die. If Satan comes and say, don't worry, you're not going to die. That shows that he is the enemy of God because he's actually questioning God's integrity and making God a liar here. What do you think Eve should have done at this point? She should have ran away. She said, okay, I know who God is. I've been walking with him every day. I'm going to go ask him. I'm going to go tell on him. I'm going to tell on you to him, right? Like how the little ones do immediately. I'm going to go tell my mommy. That's the right kind of response. But Eve failed to do that. She didn't do that. Now her curiosity like really gets bigger here. And she says over here, and he said, you're not going to die. Then she's even thinking, oh, that means I can have that fruit, right? That means in her mind, she already had it settled that I cannot have that. But once that question comes, you can actually break what God said and you can still live. Now she's thinking, oh, if there's no consequence, I can disobey, right? That's the dangerous point in a man and woman's life. If we think, because of the consequence, I'm not going to do this. And somebody comes and says, there's no consequence for this. I'm going to go over that. And I'm going to do that. Then I'm going to live in rebellion before God. That's what happened to Eve. She said, God said, don't touch this. That means don't even go near it. What did she do? She said, he said that I'm not going to die. So let me get more information from him as to how I can get that fruit that he said not to touch. And now this actually goes further. And then the serpent says, verse 4, you shall not die. And verse 5, for God knoweth that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be open, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. Now he's actually making God even much worse than what he portrayed him to be before. He called God a liar. Second, he's saying that God doesn't have your best interest. He does not want you to become wiser than him. He doesn't want you to become smarter than him. He actually wants you to be here. He wants to be up there. So go ahead and eat this. This woman believed the lie of the enemy. She actually believed what Satan said. And she stood there and she listened. See, if we love somebody, right? And if somebody is saying something bad about my daddy, what will we do? Are we going to say, is that so? Is that so? Or are we going to just burn in anger? You know how many people, even if their dad is a murderer, their child will just stand up, try to defend as much as they can. But Eve failed so miserably here. God was her dad. He created her. He gave her to Adam with high hopes that she will be his helpmate. But she was no help. She actually dragged him down. And we have to look at ourselves and ask ourselves a question. Lord, is there any part of Eve in me? Any part? It's easier for us to stand back and look at Eve and blame Eve for everything. But today, is any part of Eve in me? When God says something, and then the enemy brings thoughts in my mind saying that, that's hard. I don't think that's good. Maybe we'll go this way. I don't think that way is going to work. Can I take a shortcut? When God says, don't go to your old relationships, I find some way, try to open the Bible, close the Bible 100 times, hoping that some verse will pop up to justify going back to where I don't belong. Because my heart wants to walk that way. So I'm looking for ways to do what I want to do rather than what God wants me to do, even though I know that I shouldn't be doing that. That's what Eve did. Eve thought, Satan said something good for me to hear. I like it. And I like the fruit. I don't think there's going to be any consequence. Another thing he said was, you're going to become wiser than God. And you see, in her heart, the desire for power grows now. The innocence is gone. The faith that she had in her father was gone. She started doubting. And now she's thinking, I want to get bigger than him. I want to become like the gods. She didn't think, let me go and ask him, is this true? Let me see what he says. Even though she walked with him every day, we clearly see that she was a very independent woman. Eve was an independent woman. Independence sometimes is good, most of the times is bad. The first day a woman said, I want to be independent, that was the doomsday. Do you know that? Everything went down, from family to marriage to everything. We have like a false sense of security and accomplishment, all those things like Eve had. I'm going to get this, I'm going to get this, I'm going to get this. But once you get this, that's when you know, what have I gotten? That's what happened to Eve. Where are we standing before God? Do we think, I can do it. I can do it on my own. I don't need A. I don't need B. I don't need the advice of C. I'm smart enough. The day we think we are smart enough, that's the day we are making the dumbest choice. Really. Because the smartest person will have somebody to go to and ask, can I do this or not? A wise person will seek counsel. In counsel, the Bible says, safety. When we say I'm going to do independently, You know, people who do sneaky things a lot of times will do independently because they don't want anybody to know. And Eve did that. She listened to somebody and she said, okay, now I'm going to do this. I'm going to execute this. And she looked, you know, for support. That is her husband. How many of us know at some point in our lives we've done that? We know we shouldn't have done something. And then we go try to do that. Then we get scared. Now we want to have somebody else, right, to say, they did that too, not only me. God sees our heart. That's what happened to Eve. She started looking for power now. She wasn't satisfied in her position as the woman, princess, created in the image of God from her husband, it's Adam. She wasn't happy being a wife to Adam, having all these creatures in the creation under her. She wanted more. She said, I need to get more. I did not know until this point that I can actually get more. Now she's gotten information that I can get more, I can achieve more. We need to know. Anytime the enemy brings something through someone and says, you know what, you can get more, we need to just pause right there. We need to ask, what is the definition of more? What is the definition of more? The Bible says, be content with what you have. God has placed us in the best possible situation. An independent spirit will cause a snare to us. Rather going to the Lord and asking, this guy is telling me to do this. Is it right or is it wrong? I think something is wrong with this. You know, the conscience that God has put in our hearts, it will tell us. We will feel uncomfortable when somebody comes and tells us something wrong. We will feel uncomfortable. But the greed and the lust for power and want to achieve something, some satisfaction, ignores that, sometimes tramples on that conscience and says, I'm going to get it anyway. That's what she did. Eve would have felt uncomfortable. She would have felt nervous when she went there because she knew God told her not to. But she said, I'm going to do it anyway. I'm going to go ahead anyway because the enemy said, whether it's right or wrong, whether it's going to happen or not, she had a false sense of security. I can somehow even tell God that he said, right? The serpent said, Lord, that's why he did it and somehow get away with this. God knows everything. God sees everything. God saw what Eve did. God saw Eve when she was having a conversation with the enemy. Step number one, the Spirit of the Lord is telling us, never stand and have a conversation with the enemy. Never. Never try to say, I'm going to try to explain my way. I'm going to try to say and make them understand and make myself look good. But no, before you know, you'll be under the mire. Before you know, that's how fast Satan can drag you down. We don't have conversations with Satan. We can go tell our daddy. He will take care of Satan, right? He's the only one who has power over Satan. And if we are his daughters, then God gives us the power. But that's through him, not on our own, not to have conversation, not to do what we want to do, but what he wants us to do. So this time, by this time, in degrees, she's just going downhill very fast, very fast. She hasn't gotten hold of the tree yet. She hasn't gotten hold of the fruit yet. But the enemy said, this is going to be really good for you. Verse 6 says, when she saw that the tree was good for food, stomach, and it was pleasant for the eyes, for the senses, and a tree to be desired to make one wise, she took the fruit and she did eat, and also gave unto her husband with her, and he did eat. Now, we need to take a good look at these sentences. What did she do after all of this? She goes to the tree and she looks at the tree. When she looks at the tree looked really, really good. The fruit looked really beautiful. And her stomach is saying, it should really taste good. It's not that she was like really desperately hungry and all the trees like, you know, withered away and there was nothing there. Even then she should have gone to the Lord, but she had so much everywhere. But she said, this looks good. I'm going to get this. What the Holy Spirit wants us to know is, once we give ourselves over to the counsel of the enemy will cause an illusion before us. There could be 100 trees, very beautiful, even more beautiful than this tree. But at that moment, this tree will look more beautiful than the rest of the trees. How many of us know what I'm talking about? We have seen like how many people have made wrong choices, right? Very wrong choices. And when they turn back and they say, why did I even do this? But at that point, this tree looked so beautiful. And the stomach said, I need to get this. And the eyes said, I want this right now. And the mind said, I'm going to actually go to another state, an altered state, state like God. She wasn't satisfied that she was already in the image of God. So, God has created us three-part beings, right? Spirit, soul, and body. When the enemy comes, he doesn't just come to the body. He affects all three. He appeals to our senses. He appeals to our flesh. He appeals to our mind. Mind is connected with the soul. So he says, you make this choice, you're going to become like God. In your spirit, you're going to get like a spiritual status. In your body, it's going to satisfy your hunger and it's going to really taste good. And the way it looks, I've never seen a fruit like this. When you get something like that, beware, right? When you see false advertising, like you know, right? Yeah, I've been getting some texts too. Free 2 trips to the Bahamas. When you get something like that, or an email saying that, we've gotten emails like that. Oh, I am a Muslim widow from Pakistan, and I've become a Christian, and my husband passed away, and he has left $1 million, and I want to give it to your ministry. What do you think that email is? Yes, it's a spam. Somebody trying to get your details and trying to kill you. We need to be so careful as to who we approach or who we let or who is going to approach us. Who do we allow in our lives to come close to us? If we know how to delete those, how careful we have to be. Sometimes we lose our senses when we give room to the enemy. First step, when we allow the enemy to come close, we lose everything because he is the master. What to say? Much worse than any witch. He can cast a spell in seconds, take you down as fast as he can. Only if we allow. He can never overpower a child of God. He can never push somebody into something. But if we stand there and have a conversation and our heart is already going that direction, he has the power now. He'll say, I will drag you faster than you know. That's what happened to Eve. And she took it, she ate it, and she gave the fruit to her husband. And you know what her husband did? He was a man who liked to please his wife. He said, honey, even though God said no, I love you so much. God gave you to me. So I will tell him, you gave her to me as a helpmate, and I'm going to listen to her. And he listened to her. Is that the right thing to do? No. Sometimes we do things like that, right? We can tell the Lord, oh, God gave this blessing, and we abuse it. We have to be very careful. Every blessing God gives, he gives with a specific purpose for us to glorify God, for us to do it right. Every gift that God gives us is for us to multiply it so that God's kingdom can expand. But this woman, she took it, she gave it to her husband, and he took it, and he ate it, because he wanted to please her. He didn't have a backbone to say no to his wife. How many of us, at some point in our life, even though we knew something was wrong, didn't have a backbone to say no to the people who dragged us down because we wanted to please them? And we think that we can get away with it. We couldn't, right? Thank God, God loves us. And he comes again and he calls, Adam, where are you? He just didn't say, forget about it. I'm going to just send an angel and get them out. Away from me. I don't even want to see your faces anymore. Because what they did was so treacherous, right? In front of Satan, they actually said that God was a liar. And God was not trustworthy. And they went and took that and they ate it. And God could have done that. But God loved us so much. He came again. He clothed them. His consequences were there. But he made a way. And God is doing the same thing for us this night. Regardless of whatever choices we made in our lives, just like Eve, the Spirit of the Lord says, because of his love, he came again to the garden and he called us by our name. And God clothed us. God gave us what we needed, gave us a shelter. God brought us back again because of his love. Now, the caution that the Lord wants to give us this night is the lesson that we learned from Eve that we committed in our lives should not repeat again. There should be no repetition of what we did before in our lives again. Eve and Adam sinned, disobeyed God miserably, but you don't see them doing that again and again and again. We need to learn from our mistakes. We don't have to make mistakes, but if we made, we have to learn from it. And Genesis chapter 3, God has recorded that in the Bible for us to learn from that mistake that Adam and Eve made. And Eve, as a woman, did a terrible blunder because of what she had in her heart, because of the lust she had in her heart for more. She was not content. And the Holy Spirit is speaking to us this night. The Lord says, get rid of greed out of your life. How many of us can say, God brought me to this Walter Owing home, but I'm not content here? There are people there. That's what the Holy Spirit is showing me. God brought me here. I was miserable there, but God brought me here. But now I feel like I'm more miserable here. That's a lie from the enemy. That is the lie from the enemy. The enemy will say it's more miserable for you to be a child of God. It's more freedom out there. The children of Israel did that. They were beaten by the Egyptians. They were not given food. They were crying out to God. God brought them out with a strong and mighty arm into the wilderness on their way to the promised land, but they couldn't put up with that wilderness for a short time. They started throwing tantrums. They said, I was happy in my Egypt. I got this, I got that. They forgot the beatings they got. They forgot that they were slaves. Now they're free. They forgot how much they cried out for freedom. We don't want to be like that. We never want to be like that. We don't want to say, Lord, I'm just tired of this place. Lord, I just want to get out. Maybe I can go somewhere else or find a job. Remember that this is a shelter God has given. There's a verse in the Bible. It says, humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. In due time, he will lift you up. That means there's a time in your life. There's a time in my life where I need to stay humble where God places me. Even if it means I don't like the place. Understand? Even if you say I don't like it, God says, learn to like it. You know that? Really. I don't know if I said it here once, but I know somewhere I said it once. I never liked broccoli. I never liked broccoli when I first came to the U.S. 18 years ago. And when I got pregnant with my first son, I had to eat broccoli because it had calcium. Every day I used to eat broccoli. Broccoli, before you knew, because even before that, if I get my husband got any Chinese food, I used to take all the broccoli and keep it away. We never had broccoli in India, you know, at least where we lived. Then I started eating broccoli every day. Before you know, I started liking broccoli. And when I started cooking, I started putting broccoli. You become what you eat, and what you practice, you really start liking it. You know that? If you practice eating hot and spicy food, that's what you like it. If you practice eating bland food, that's what you like it. If you practice living a good life, that's what you like it. And how many of you know, if you stay away from sugar for some time and be on a healthy diet, then you start eating junk food. After some time, you feel, I want sugar, I want candy, I want cookie, right? Once you start eating. Until that time, you'll be doing good. When you give ourselves over to something that's not good, it's much harder to break that. So we need to take great caution. God is speaking to us. God says, guard the freedom that I've given you. Guard the deliverance that I've given you. Be thankful for where you are and be content in the situation where I've placed you. In due time, I'm going to lift you up. Wait for your due time. When you pass through the desert, I will be with you. When you walk through fires, I will be with you. When you go through the rivers, I will be with you. It's not going to roll over you. But do you say, Lord, I don't want river. I don't want desert. I don't want fire. I want to walk alone. I would rather go through a desert with Jesus Christ. Rather go through fire with Jesus Christ. Rather go through water with Jesus Christ than to walk alone in some beautiful garden without the Lord. God is so good. Because just like the submarine, I've never seen that before, but today worship time, the Lord showed me a submarine. And the submarine is in water, it's going without it being affected by anything around it. God, by his mercies, has insulated us with the blood of Jesus. We have all these things around us. Unless I open the door to the submarine and let water in, I'm not going to go down. Unless I open the door for the enemy to come in, I'm going to grow stronger and stronger and stronger in the Lord. That is the intention of God for each one of your lives. He wants us to go from glory to glory, faith to faith. Keep progressing. Keep progressing. The other thing that the Lord wants me to tell you now is, once you're done with the program, I don't know how many of you are going to graduate, how many of you are going to leave, I have no idea, but the Lord wants me to speak on this issue. Some of you, once you are done with this, once you go out of this, whether you go for an internship or go somewhere else, do not have any conversation with the agent of Satan. Do not. Don't say, you know what? The feeling will come. The feeling will come to call your ex-boyfriend. The feeling will come to call your ex-partner, whoever it is, agent of Satan. Write it in your heart. Those were the agents of Satan, and those are still the agents of Satan, unless they are a brand new creature in the Lord. Don't say, I'm going to call and see how they are doing. I'm not going to go. I'm just going to call and see. Don't make that first call, because that will be your doomsday. Write it down today. Do not have conversation with Satan. If somebody calls you, if that serpent comes to you and talks to you, just like Joseph did, run as fast as you can, as far as you can. Do not pick up. Don't say, I don't want to offend A, I don't want to offend B, I want to look good. If you think you want to look good in front of the agent of Satan, he will kill you. Don't try to sympathize the serpent. Don't try to be friendly with the serpent. You cannot be nice to everyone, can you? Can you be nice to everyone? No. If I try to be nice to everyone, if I try to please everyone, I'm going to go down fast. We need to learn to say no. No to Satan. I tell my children this all the time. I say, the word no should not be in your dictionary other than only one case. When you say no to Satan, that's when your no has to come strong and loud to Satan. For everything else, I say, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I never say no. I never say, I can't do this. I'm not going to do this. No, I tell my children, you don't say no for anything else. Whatever God has called you to do, God has equipped you. And he's given you the strength. use it. But when Satan comes near you, you give a shout, loud, angry no to the enemy. The enemy needs to get it. Otherwise, the enemy will stand and he'll keep talking. He'll keep knocking. But when we say, I don't want to have any part with you, like the Bible says, resist the devil. How many of you know what it means to resist the devil? We need to really resist the devil. We can't just rub the devil and say, I'm so sorry, I apologize. I'm not going to talk to you. I really apologize. Don't feel so bad. I'm not meaning to hurt you. I really apologize. No apologies to the agent of Satan. No. There's no regret, right? When you're doing what is right before God, there's no regret. Amen. Be ruthless with the enemy. Never embrace the enemy. Be very careful. He is your enemy. He's God's enemy. Therefore, he's your enemy. So be very careful when you leave this place. Be very careful of your association, who you're going to associate with. Be careful with the serpent that will come. There's a prophecy God is speaking to you. I don't say things randomly. This is a prophecy that the Lord is speaking to you, that the enemy, the old serpent, will come. He will try to start a conversation. He will try to say nice things to you. Don't stop and listen. And God will bless you. We're going to close our eyes. We're going to go into prayer. And we're going to pray for some of you who God is going to touch you. God is going to heal you today. God is going to deliver you. But before that, we're going to make a strong commitment to the Lord and say, Lord, I'm going to say no to where I need to say no, to whom I need to say no, with everything that's within me. Shall we close our eyes? Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do we have the spine to say no? Adam didn't have it. Hallelujah. We never had it many times in our lives. Today is a time that the Lord is speaking to us. He says, you need to develop that. I have given you the spine. Use it. Don't try to please everyone. If you please everyone, you're going to fall because of that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Learn to say no when you have to say no. Learn to say no to the agents of Satan. Hallelujah. Don't even stand and have a conversation with the agents of Satan. Hallelujah. Let God deal with them. Hallelujah. You can pray for them. Hallelujah. But don't associate yourself. Hallelujah. Praise you. Praise you. Praise you. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Praise you. Hallelujah. Don't discredit the goodness of God in your life. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Shall we all stand up? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise you. Praise you. Praise you. Praise you. Praise you. Hallelujah.
You did not wait for me to draw near to you, but you clothed yourself in frail humanity. You did not wait for me to cry out to you, but you let me hear your voice.
We worship you, hallelujah. We worship you, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Praise you, praise you, praise you, hallelujah. Praise you, Lord, hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit wants me to pray for some of you who are here, but your heart is not here, hallelujah. You know what I mean, because you know that the Holy Spirit is talking to you. Your body is here, your mind is elsewhere. Even though you know that you've been rescued and you've been put here, your heart wants to run away. Even though you know that you got abused before, you still want the abuser. The Holy Spirit is talking to you. God did not create you to be abused by any man. God did not create you to be abused by any woman. God created you in Christ Jesus unto good works. Hallelujah. If your heart says, I want to go back, know that voice is from your enemy. Hallelujah. 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 I'm going to pray for you this night for God to give you inner strength to resist the enemy. Hallelujah. I'm going to pray for you tonight that you get strong inside to say a loud no to the enemy. Hallelujah. You don't want to be living in your past. Hallelujah. You can't go forward if you're holding on to the past. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If that is you, wherever you are, raise your hand. I'm going to pray for you. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask the Lord Jesus Christ to give you strength in your mind. Hallelujah. To give you deliverance in your mind, because your past is holding you captive. Hallelujah. Because you're being held captive, you're unable to experience freedom. Hallelujah. You're not able to enjoy what God has for you, even in this wilderness. Hallelujah. God has taken you out of Egypt and He is bringing you through the wilderness to take you into the promised land. Hallelujah. But your mind is saying, I want to run back to slavery. Hallelujah. I want to run back into bondage. Hallelujah. God is giving you a strong warning this night. Hallelujah. I don't know your circumstances. I don't know your mind. But the Holy Spirit is showing me that you have a very strong inclination to go back. And God is speaking to you. He's showing Himself alive to you. Hallelujah. If that is you, raise your hand. Hallelujah. In your heart, if you're holding on to the past, hallelujah. If you say, Lord, I want deliverance, raise your hand. I'm going to pray for you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I come against the spirit of bondage in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And I come against the enemy that is holding these dear women captive to their past. I curse those demonic spirits in Jesus' name. I take victory in Jesus' name. And I come against every evil spirit that is working through people, that is drawing them into an abusive lifestyle. I curse those powers of darkness right now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. According to the power and authority given to me by the Almighty God, I curse every abusive spirit in Jesus' name. I curse every demonic spirit that wants to be abused. I curse you in Jesus' name. And I take victory in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The Lord is showing me some of you have been abused so much, you say, I don't even know how to live free anymore. I don't even know what freedom is anymore. God is saying, there is freedom in Christ Jesus. I want you to experience real love. I want you to experience real freedom. Hallelujah. I want to set you free this night. Hallelujah. 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 You're saying, Lord, my mind is totally messed up. If that is you, raise your hand. I'm going to pray for your mind. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If your mind is totally messed up and you don't know how to even think properly, God is going to make that crooked path straight in your mind. Hallelujah. 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 Raise your hand. I'm going to pray for you. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. According to the power and authority given to me by the Almighty God, I come against every perverse mind in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I remove the powers of darkness over the minds of your people in Jesus' name. And I ask you, Father, for a sound mind in Jesus' name. I ask you for a sound mind in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I ask you for a fearless mind in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I ask you for a mind full of love in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And I ask you, Heavenly Father, oh, Rahati Adolushia Adolo, some of you, the Holy Spirit is showing me that you are so cold inside that you don't even know how to love anymore. Hallelujah. You're saying, I cannot love anyone. I don't know how to love. I've never been loved. If that is you, raise your hand. I'm going to pray for you. Hallelujah. Oh, Rahada la shahadi arada la shiyondala. Hallelujah. Oh, it is important for us to admit in front of the living God. Hallelujah. If you need help, raise your hand. I'm going to pray for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. May the spirit of love come upon you. Hallelujah. God will give you love and he will make you a person who will love. Hallelujah. The unlovable. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just like Jesus did. He loved us when we were unlovable. Hallelujah. He will make you a person who will love others who are unlovable. Hallelujah. If you don't know how to love, God is going to make you a person. Hallelujah. He will teach you. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, I pray for the dear people. Lord, who are struggling, Father, to live, who don't know how to love. Lord, who say that I don't even know how to love. I don't know the definition of love. All I've seen is abuse. Spirit of the living God, I pray, pour your love, O Jesus. Pour your love, Lord. Pour your love in the name of Jesus. Whoever has sincerely raised their hands, pour your love in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. May the love from the Almighty God descend into their spirit, soul, body, and mind right now. May they feel the love of the Holy Spirit. May they feel the love of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. May they feel the embrace of the Lord Jesus Christ right now. Hallelujah. And may delivering power deliver them from years of bondage in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Oh, I thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. The Spirit of the Lord is showing me split personality. Hallelujah. Some of you are happy and you're over happy when you're happy. And when you're down, you're overly sad and sorrowful. And sometimes you go even to the point of thinking about suicide. Hallelujah. God is going to touch you and God is going to heal you this night. Hallelujah. The healing virtue of Jesus Christ is flowing here. The healing virtue of Jesus Christ is flowing everywhere. Hallelujah. God wants to heal your personality. If you have personality disorder, I'm not going to ask you to raise your hand. God understands that. Wherever you are, just cry out to him. I'm going to pray for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Rahada la shahadi arada la darashi and the Lord. The virtue of Jesus Christ is flowing here. As the woman with the issue of blood touched the hem of the garment of Jesus Christ and she received a healing. Receive your healing right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Abba Father. Oh Jesus, you came to heal the brokenhearted. And I bring these dear children into your hands. Hallelujah. Oh, as the parents brought the little ones and laid them, oh Lord, on your lap. Oh Jesus, I'm laying these precious daughters of thine. Oh Father, on your lap, into your embrace. Hallelujah. Heal their personality, Lord, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Every schizophrenic behavior, I come against you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You split personality, I come against you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You foul spirit of darkness, I come against you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you tormenting spirit, I curse your powers in Jesus' name. And I set these daughters free in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And I take victory over these powers of darkness in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. May the spirit of peace rule and reign over them. May the spirit of peace come upon them right now. May the spirit of peace come upon them right now. May the spirit of peace come upon them right now. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. The Lord is showing me some of you are living a double life. Hallelujah. This is very different from split personality. You always want to please people. So you always say nice things. When you have hatred in your heart, you have vengeance in your heart, you have bitterness in your heart, you have anger in your heart. You come across as a sweet person, but you know that you're a very bitter person inside. God wants to set you free from years of bitterness. Hallelujah. Oh, rahti andalua dala shahadara dala shio. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, I praise you. Praise you. And God wants to heal you right now. Hallelujah. He wants to heal your soul. Hallelujah. Oh, he wants to heal your soul. Hallelujah. Jesus wants to heal your soul. Hallelujah. Oh, we thank you. 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 If that is you, confess to the Lord and say, Lord, forgive me. Forgive me, Lord, for leading a double life. Forgive me for being a person, Lord, on the outside and a different person on the inside. Hallelujah. Lord, wash me with your precious blood. Cleanse me, Jesus. Cleanse me, Jesus. Cleanse me, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, help me to have a life of truth. Hallelujah. Help me to live a life of truth. Hallelujah. When people open my heart and see, may they see what they see outside. Hallelujah. Lord, may I be the same on the inside and outside. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I ask you, Heavenly Father, to give your children the grace to live a life of truth. Hallelujah. A life of truth, hallelujah. And I come against every spirit of bitterness. I come against every spirit of anger. Oh, Lord, that is preventing them. Every spirit of self, every self-centered nature, oh, that is working in them, that is keeping them from becoming that God, what God wants them to be. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I bind those demonic spirits in Jesus' name. I take victory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, healing river, healing river. Healing river is here, hallelujah. The healing river is here, hallelujah. The healing river is here, hallelujah. The healing river is here, hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit, hallelujah. The baptizer, the deliverer, hallelujah. Oh, the Lord God who sanctifies, hallelujah. Oh, the Lord God who heals, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, oh, I ask you, for a healing river to Umdari Adalushio. Lord, go into the hearts and minds of your people. Hallelujah. Lord, I thank you. 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 Hallelujah. Oh, Dali Hadalushio. Whatever disorder that you have in your body, whatever disorder that you have in your mind, whatever disorder that you have in your soul, God wants to heal right now. Hallelujah. God wants to heal right now. Hallelujah. Any kind of disorder. Hallelujah. Any form of disorder. Hallelujah. Any chronic disorder. Hallelujah. God wants to heal right now. Hallelujah. Oh, the healing river is here. Hallelujah. Healing river is here. Hallelujah. If you believe, you shall see the glory of God. Hallelujah. You shall see the glory of God. Hallelujah. As Jesus Christ is walking here, oh, touch the hem of his garment in faith. Hallelujah. Touch the hem of his garment in faith. Hallelujah. Oh, the Allahadulushia Riyadalo. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh, may the healing virtue of Jesus Christ. Oh, that is going row by row by row by row. Hallelujah. Oh, may it touch the hearts and minds of the people. Hallelujah. Oh, may the healing virtue of Jesus Christ transform the minds of your people. Hallelujah. May the healing virtue of Jesus Christ, Lord, touch the bodies of your people, Lord. Lord, whatever disease, Lord, whatever disorder, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, may it dissolve in the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, Lord, we praise you. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah, praise you. If you've never given your heart to the Lord, hallelujah, God wants to come in your life. God wants to live in your life. God wants you to become his daughter. Hallelujah. And live forevermore with him as his princess. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord wants me to give and also call for that. If you've never given your heart to Jesus Christ, and today you say, Lord, I want you, Jesus, because all the benefits of the cross is only for his children. Hallelujah. All the benefits of the cross, oh, is for the blood-washed people. Hallelujah. If you want to become one of his children and enjoy all the benefits of the cross, hallelujah. Oh, and live a fearless life. Hallelujah. Live a life above reproach. Hallelujah. Live a life that is pleasing to God. Hallelujah. Live a life that would be productive for God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give your life over to Jesus. And God says he will make you the head. And you shall not be the tail. You shall lend to many nations. And you shall not borrow. Hallelujah. God will bless you beyond more. you can imagine. Hallelujah. But you need to walk in His ways. Live a life that is pleasing to the Lord. And all the blessings God has for you will overtake. Hallelujah. It will overtake. Hallelujah. It'll overtake. Hallelujah. 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 If you want Jesus Christ to come into your heart, if you want to become a child of God, wherever you are, raise your hand and I'm going to pray for you. Hallelujah. Wherever you are, just raise your hand. If you never made a full commitment to the Lord, you want to make a commitment to the Lord, say, Lord, I want to become your daughter. Hallelujah. Raise your hand wherever you are and I'm going to pray. Just repeat this prayer after me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Say, Lord Jesus, please repeat this after me. Whoever raised your hands, Lord Jesus, forgive me of all my sins.
Forgive me of all my sins.
Cleanse me, Lord.
Cleanse me, Lord.
Of all the wrong things that I've said.
Of all the wrong things that I've said.
All the wrong things that I've thought.
All the wrong things that I've thought.
And wrong things I've done.
The wrong things that I've done.
I truly feel sorry, Lord.
I truly feel sorry, Lord.
Wash me, Jesus.
Wash me, Jesus.
I'm not worthy to be your daughter.
I'm not worthy, Lord, to be your daughter.
But thank you, Lord, for giving me the opportunity.
Thank you, Lord, for giving me the opportunity.
And I want to make use of it. Lord, I want to become your daughter.
Lord, I want to become your daughter.
Come into my life. Be my Lord.
Be my Lord.
Oh, Father, help me, Jesus, to live for you.
Help me,
Jesus, to love you.
Help me, Jesus, to love you.
Help me, Lord, to serve you.
Help me, Lord, to serve you.
Help me, Lord, to follow you till the day I die.
Help me, Lord, to follow you till the day I die.
Help me to be where you are.
Help me to be where you are.
Jesus, help me.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father. I believe that you died for me.
I believe that you died for me.
I believe that you rose again for me.
I believe that you rose again for me.
I believe that you're coming back for me.
I believe that you're coming back for me.
And I believe that you're living with me.
And I believe that you're living with me.
And from this day forward,
from this day forward,
I believe that you will lead me.
I believe that you will lead me.
And I thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Thank you, Father. Lord, I pray for the dear people who've given their hearts to you. Thank you for writing their names in the Lamb's Book of Life. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for, Lord, there was a great celebration in heaven, and we thank you. I pray, give them, Lord, a steady mind, a steady heart, firm heart, Lord, to stay true to their commitment to you, Jesus. We thank you. And the last altar call I'm going to give is for those of you who have backslidden. You have been backslidden, but you've been doing your routine reading, routine praying. But you know you've been backslidden in your heart. God is giving you an opportunity to come back to Him. Hallelujah. There's no pretense in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Yes. Nobody is looking. You don't have to worry. Even if somebody looks, you don't have to worry. It is between you and God. Jesus publicly died for you. Hallelujah. Yes. He publicly died for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, if you've gone far away from the Lord, if you've drifted away from God, and you want to come back, you want to make a total commitment to the Lord. Say, Lord, I do not want to be like Eve anymore. Lord, but I want to become your daughter. I want to live a life that is pleasing to you. You've called me to be more than a conqueror. Hallelujah. And I want to live like that, Jesus. If that is you, raise your hand. I'm going to pray for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you want to make a recommitment to God, say, Lord, I've drifted away from you. I'm coming back to you. If that is you, raise your hand. I'm going to pray for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, I pray for these dear women who are recommitting their lives to you. You see their hearts. And I pray, Heavenly Father, Lord, that you'll draw them to you, Jesus.
Lord,
wherever you are, tell the Lord, Lord, forgive me.
Lord,
I want to go forward. Hallelujah. I want to go forward. Hallelujah. Lord, I've betrayed you so many times by my actions. I've betrayed you so many times in my thoughts. Not anymore, Father.
I give myself to you
to follow you faithfully.
Not to be like Eve.
Lord, not to please people like Adam.
Lord, not to please people like Adam.
But I want to be true to you till the day I die.
And I want to be true to you till the day I die.
And I commit myself to that cause.
I commit myself to that cause.
Thank you, Father. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Let's open our mouth and thank Him. Hallelujah. Thank you for the work of God that was accomplished. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for your work that you did. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you for doing it. Hallelujah. We commit ourselves into your hands. One more time, we commit each and every single person who's seated here, who's standing here this night, to be with them. Go with them, oh Father, wherever they go. To their rooms, go with them, Jesus. May your word continue to work in their hearts throughout the night, Father. Speak to them through dreams and visions, oh Lord. Oh, may they wake up with Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, may they live with Jesus. Hallelujah. May they walk with Jesus. Hallelujah. May they talk with Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, may there be a drastic change in their lives, oh Lord. And thank you for doing it. Thank you for doing it. In Jesus' name I pray. Hallelujah. Praise you. Praise you. Praise you. Hallelujah.
You deserve the glory.